Hi, I'm Stephanie. It's March, it's the coming of spring, which means it's also time for China's annual two sessions meeting. Thousands of delegates from all of China's regions, provinces, ethnic groups will be arriving here for this important governmental meeting. And that's what made me hit the streets today. I'm interested to hear what local Beijingers have to say. Zoba. So, we're going to play a game for the two sessions. Can you spin the wheel? Ah. And our topic is education.
So, I think because I'm a Beijing graduate, I think that in the university, for me, the biggest problem is about the job. I think that the job of the graduate is a very big problem. 障碍，然后我希望我们就是政府能够对大学生的就业能有更多的帮助，有更多的扶持。
Pandemic control.
中国的模式可以其实就挺好的，就是全民防控啊，那个包括自己的那个，就是包括口罩也好，还是。 大家平常的一些个注意的方法，就是方式方法都挺好的，就这样了。
The Chinese government can be a little difficult for us Westerners to understand just because it's so different from Western models of government, but there are similarities. Like in the West, China's regions and provinces have representatives like governors or members of parliament. And that's not all. Governments worldwide are relying more and more on technology to have open dialogues with their people.
For the past 7 years, China has rolled out an online initiative called A Word to the Premier to solicit public feedback on government work in an effort to further improve public policies.
Members of the public were invited to weigh in on 22 separate topics, everything from pandemic control to education, for technology and innovation, culture and sports. Let's go find some people to talk to. Yes, okay. You know, you got it. Job opportunities. Jobs.
对，就业现在就是比较火的，就是零工经济吧。 就是一份工作不够啊，还是需要，就是多一些选择，然后还有就是这个主业呢，一方面，另外一方面还是要多一些，就是说啊，那相关的副业，现在就是说很好的就是，可选择性也比较多，然后呢，只要是说肯去想，肯去做一些东西，就是这些新的媒体啊，也带来一些机会。
就可以就是在家也可以做一些自己愿意做的选择，所以就是机会的选择更多了，不像以前就是一份工要打到底。Spin the wheel. Technology.
我觉得现在科技发展还是比较迅速的，但是对于生活上的一些科技，我觉得还是比较匮乏的，就是现在的科技都应用在一些。 高薪的领域什么，对于生活上，我觉得提升还是比较慢一些。就希望能科技能更多的应用在民生啊、生活之类的。
关于养生健康这一块，我觉得，因为我的父母嘛，我是属于80后，上有老下有小，然后我也是比较关注父母这块的健康，就是希望呢。 我们是把一些保健类的产品能够更好的走入家庭，因为现在是大健康产业嘛，就是希望不是在有病的情况下再去投靠医院，这样的话我们把健康这一方真是走入家庭，让每个人都是健健康康的，这样的话也是减少我们80后这方面的负担。关于孩子这一方面，主要是目前来说强身健体嘛，给他们一个打下一个良好的基础，别的就是没有什么了，谢谢。
2020 saw over 1,400 pieces of advice make it to the drafting group. Clearly, the Chinese people are making their voices heard. What about you? What important issues do you most want to see addressed during 2021's two sessions? Let me know in the comments. Until then, I'm going to swap this for one of these. 老板, 来一串? 啊, 谢谢。 谢谢。
good.